Hello everybody, and welcome back to the Ōkami walkthrough. It's time for the finale. It's time to try and defeat the evil force that has been destroying Nippon since the beginning. And hopefully we will find out what the hell has been going on. So here we go, it's time for our final boss fight against Yami. After that insanely epic cutscene in which we found out that Waka was the guy who brought the Ark of Yamato to the Celestials, bringing pain and destruction with him. But he feels regret for that, and he's trying to atone for his sins. Which, I think, I adore that cutscene, because for all the frustration that you can feel with Waka until then, it really does solidify him as one of the best characters in Ōkami. Because he's kind of so mysterious, and then you get that reveal, and oh, it's wonderful. And also, we have this amazing fight against Yami. Music right now is, I believe, Emperor of Eternal Darkness. Which makes sense, because Yami's Japanese name is Tokuyami no Tsumeragi, which is Emperor of Everlasting Darkness. Now, obviously, he has many forms, and we will go through them eventually, but the first one is kind of recollecting a whole bunch of our brush techniques, because Yami is an evil sod. The more you beat down on him, the more you will get back. Just gotta keep safe, and it'll all be fine. Yami means darkness, gloom, and despair, metaphorically, so I mean that'll make sense. And I should probably deal with what he appears like in the art book. So this character ended up with the name Yami the Dark Lord, but during the design stages it was called Empty Death, which is what this first form was called. And it was a demon taken from ancient legends. It is mentioned towards the end of the image scrolls of the Pearl Archives, and is said to have crushed all the other demons. Truly this was the ultimate demon. In one numeric system, Empty Death is assigned the number 0, and is designed with a distinctively circular theme. I honestly think it is the perfect demon to be the ultimate enemy in Ōkami. I'd put so much of myself into this design that it felt strangely distressing when they decided to change its name. I hope that someday I will have the opportunity to further work on this character, and have it make another appearance somewhere in some other form. And I don't know whether the design actually had that wish come true, but Yami appears as the main antagonist in Tatsunoko vs. Capcom, cross-generation of heroes / ultimate all-stars. So, Yami did return. Now, I do have a slight bit of information, I believe, about the design of the final boss arena. So, various constellations are displayed on the dome ceiling, and there's also a device that can simulate different atmospheres and environments, so make sure to use your brush techniques as much as possible in this fight. The Nazca line drawing for Yami, which you will have seen throughout the Ark of Yamato, it's a cursed symbol known to represent a divine death. So, I mean, it's terrifying. I can't seem to specifically get anything to do with Empty Death, but just know that that is a thing. So, we are currently on Yami's second form, and now that we have brush techniques like crescents, there are certain brush techniques throughout this fight that you can use that will bring forth your allies to help. So using crescent will bring forth, I think it's Nagi. Yes. And that is how you're going to kind of cause mass damage. There are other allies that will assist us, depending on what move you use. So it's really fun to kind of make use of all of your brush techniques, because then you get to see those allies helping you out in such an awesome way. Now, for all that's said, the first kind of bit of this fight isn't quite as cool as he could be. That said, I have to say that this boss is more a boss of ideas and making use of all of your brush techniques than being a kind of terrifying boss design, if that makes any sense. I mean, I think Sugar Conroy came up with the whole theory that each of these stages in Yami's kind of design is to do with, like, the horror of man. Whether you agree with that is a different matter, but it's a pretty gosh darn reasonable way of looking at Yami. I probably should just deal with his bestiary entries, because they're quite interesting. So the first form, the thing was, this horrifying entity has been called Empty Death. It seeks complete destruction. For eons it has been locked in a struggle with the Sun God. This fight has been described thusly. Yami's destruction was countered by the Sun God's rejuvenation, signalling that you get rejuvenation during that first phase. Second form, round, cold, and desolate as the moon. Yami has never been depicted as a human or animal in any drawing. It is simply too inorganic in appearances to warrant such portrayals. Yami took on a ring form when attacked, rendering blows useless. The beast was bathed in moonlight, the light acting as a blade. Signal using crescent for Nami to appear. In most legends, this is for the third phase, gods are portrayed as good or evil, as representations of specific animals. This is not the case of the dreaded Yami. Yami belched fire and ice, but the god deflected the onslaught. The beast attacked violently, with speed and unpredictability. Only by slowing the flow of time could the sun god defend itself. And we've just gotten Veil of Mist, and that is exactly how we're going to defend ourselves. Using the Veil of Mist, we'll summon forth Himiko, and she will help us. Now, that said, I don't think that Veil of Mist does you a whole lot of good, because you kind of want to be slashing straight through, and sometimes you'll get kind of a pretty decent ride. But you want to get pretty much, I think it's three of the same tends to deal with him. Or things that you can kind of hit back. That always seems to help quite a lot. You've just got to kind of reflect as much as possible. Now, this fight isn't going quite as brilliantly as I probably would have hoped. I would have wanted like a perfect run, but it's simply not going to happen. I'm not that good at Ōkami. But I still, I love this fight so much, more so for what's going to happen in a bit than anything else. But I do think it's a really good way of closing out the game. It's perfect, really. Now, you may have noticed that there's lots of kind of graphical glitches going on with Yami's kind of graphics. It's ridiculous. I'm pretty sure the Wii version is the only instance where that happens. It's just something to do with, I think, the way he's designed. It freaks out, well and truly. And also, you probably noticed that there was a rather awful audio glitch in that last cutscene, which is heartbreaking. Because it's a wonderful cutscene, and then you get the roar of Ōkami. Kind of really delayed. It's ridiculous. But then we have catwalk, which is actually the only brush technique I'm not using in this fight, because it's useless. The reason I say it's useless is because, I mean, The only thing it will allow you to do is climb up those pillars there. And while there are chests up those pillars, they serve very little purpose. You're just going to be wanting to continue facing down Yami, because he should be your primary concern. Anyway, for the fourth form of Yami, his bestiary entry reads as such. Its inorganic nature resembles machinery, leading one gadgetry expert to speculate that it is likely the source of all machines. When the goddess hacked with thunder, the machine coughed forth a seed. When the beast drew it back in, the god knew it must be the core. The beast tried to seal away its core with an icy blast, obviously signaling that we're going to be getting Blizzard shortly. There's Thunderstorm, so now we can actually fight back whenever he does that, thank the Lord. And for some reason, the core decides to come out of his backside, but we'll roll with that. Now, I should point out, I did have to actually re-record this fight because I had a recording glitch. Basically, my hoppage, I don't even know how you pronounce it anymore, I'll go with hoppage. It just cut out in the middle of recording this fight, and I was so annoyed. So very annoyed. I mean, I think the fight had been going rather well until then, and then it just decided, nope, you're not allowed to have a nice, smooth run. Or it might have been a horrible run, so I was slightly quite grateful. Still could have probably gone slightly smoother on the whole, but I'm still really happy with this run. It gives me enough time, well, it has given me enough time to go through everything that I needed to do with Yami. Now obviously, now that we have Blizzard, we can freeze the core, and it means that we can just absolutely obliterate it. This fight's probably the most difficult one to face, just because you have a lot going on. And he doesn't always behave himself. He'll sometimes do things that you're not quite expecting, which can be frustrating. But we're going to try and just get through this now as quickly as possible. I probably should have been using my items sooner, but you know what I'm like. I don't use my items. It's not in my nature. I think because obviously the way items work in Bayonetta, I just don't need to use them, or don't feel the need to use them anyway. Although, you do sometimes wish you did when you have situations where you're just getting thrown, well, everything's getting thrown at you. Here we go, this should be either, okay, that was the penultimate cycle, I think, on Yami. We should be able to deal with him in his next, as soon as we can stop him, he should be down for the count, basically. Now, I do find it rather annoying when that closes up when you go into the Celestial Brush mode. I don't know what kind of triggers it, but either way, it's frustrating. But I think, like, one more hit. Please, one more hit. There we go. Yami's defeated! I hope. And now we're gonna get my favourite cutscene in the entirety of Ōkami. Like, this sequence from now until the end of the game is just... it's perfect. Like, so... entirely perfect. I love it so much.
I'm going to go to the next one.
Oh. Just. I'm sure you can tell why I love that cutscene so much, and just the run into this fight. So we had the absolutely beautiful reset thank you version, which just, that cutscene just makes me cry every single time. It's just been sitting here, just tears flooding down my cheeks, because I'm an absolute softy at heart. And just, and then we had Ōkami White Light, or something along those lines. And then we move into the stunning The Sun Rises. Because obviously, kind of literally and metaphorically, it's the rise of the sun god against the darkness. And just, whatever frustrations you may have had with Yami before this, this final phase is just outstanding. And it's because of the way it's all been set up and into this. Bestiary entry for the final form is, in all these tales there is no record of a decisive victor. Has no one emerged victorious, or was the event simply not recorded? As the darkness tries to cover all, forget not the warmth of purifying light. Prayer is power. Power is prayer. And I think that's a very affecting statement. And I think the thing that I love so much about all of this, because obviously we've now become Shiranui because the people believe in us, and because you have been helping the people of Nippon in earning their praise and their belief, it now comes full circle because they believe in you and Ōkami as a god. And it's just, it's phenomenal. It's the only way I can describe it. And I mean, it's situations like this which are proof of why Hideki Kamiya is such a great video game director, and why the folks at Platinum and then Clover are so good at what they do. Because, I mean, mostly Hideki Kamiya in terms of the overall art, because they know how to make a satisfying experience. Like, we've been on such a long journey, and this just closes off everything so wonderfully that you kind of forget the problems you had with the game, and even with any issues you may have had with the first kind of bit of the boss fight, because there is the potential for seeing this as an anticlimax. But really, I don't think I do. I think it's a wonderful conclusion to the game, and just, I can't gush enough. I really can't. This entire sequence just makes my day. It really does. That Yami is going to be very, very nearly defeated. Like, I don't think he's going to survive much more of our onslaught. And with that, Yami the Dark Lord is defeated. The final boss is done, and Ōkami is beaten. And there we have it. We're at the credits for Ōkami and... Oh! Now, obviously, in the Wii version, you would not be getting these credits. You would just kind of have cut off really, really bluntly. Then it's gone into the ending stuff. So we had the journey continues and then to Tamagahara. But thanks to the magic of editing, and because there's no way I'm letting this walkthrough finish at such a kind of blunt, harsh note, we're going to see the wonder of the credits and the stinger. So this has been taken from the PS2 version. I borrowed it permanently off of someone on YouTube. I can't remember where, but this is all down to YouTube being a wonderful thing. Music is Reset. Obviously, this particular song is the basis for Reset's thank you version, and it's performed by Ayaka Hirahara. And I think that this song and this kind of credits roll is a perfect way of ending the game, because it's all about the journey and kind of the lyrics interpret one's feeling of seeing a beautiful scene fading away with time. So, like saying that you don't see how beautiful something is or how important it is until it's lost and it can't be experienced again. So, kind of, the intention is for it to represent the feeling of the closure of the journey and Ami returning to the celestial plane. And you may experience a bit kind of sadness that it's over. Obviously you can do a new playthrough, but it's a song that kind of is just like, just in the end be happy, and even though things are over, just you can just purge yourself of those feelings and be happy, because you can move on and move forward, and that is what you should do. And I think that that kind of encapsulates Ōkami as a whole. It's about restoring beauty to the world, kind of finding the good in everything, and living life to the fullest, and doing good for other people. And I love this game so much. It has a few problems, don't get me wrong, but... and especially the Wii version, considering it cut this wonderful sequence. But I just love it so much. And then you get like these wonderful little pictures which show like what happened afterwards. So like Oki and Glika and Thamical facing down the Namahage. Otohime with her child. There's the wonderful, wonderful director that is Hideki Kamiya. He had a shot of the canine warriors, and this credits roll is among my favourite credit rolls of all time. In fact, I think Hideki Kamiya has a pretty much straight run. I love all of his credit sequences. Just as I love pretty much all of his games. So, it makes me happy. And we get to see that Kushi and Susano had a little baby. Which is adorable. And there is the stamp, which has been obviously edited in because it wouldn't be there otherwise. Wonders of editing. And that concludes this most secret of tales. Well then, I'd say that's enough storytelling for today. This story contains the hopes and dreams of many fine people. Keep it close to your heart and cherish it. What's that? You want to know why I alone know this tale that no one knows? You listened to the whole story and never figured it out? You missed the whole point. Jeez, what's wrong with you? I suppose I'll have to tell the whole story all over again. You'd best learn to show my brush the respect it deserves. Anyway, I'm tired. Let's call it a day. If you're eager to hear more, I can tell you the rest of the story some other time. Until then, do your best to live up to the heroes I told you about. It's time to roll this scroll up and give it a title. Ōkami Amatersau's Adventure. Come back again, okay? Until next time. And now we get our final results. 36 hours, 24 minutes, 50 seconds of playtime, 67 days passed, 85 saves, 0 deaths, 777 enemies defeated, a whole ridiculous amount of money, a whole ridiculous amount of demon fangs, lots of praise, and yes, basically, we have collected everything. We had a wonderful congratulations screen, and now we're going to unlock everything that is possible to unlock in Ōkami. Presents from Issun, all these comic transformers, which I will go into in the extras, final stray bead, the string of beads, which you get for collecting all of the stray beads, and just loads of goodies, which we will deal with in the extras. So, I hope you have enjoyed the Ōkami walkthrough. I hope you join me in the extras. If not, I hope you will see me in the next playthrough or walkthrough. Until next time.